Let's start this record always. Just wait 1 minute. It is recording. Okay, now. One.
Good afternoon, sir.
Yes, good afternoon. Good afternoon. Just 1 minute. Yeah, I didn't save the yesterday slide. So let's start this class. We have very limited time, so let's proceed. So desktop. My screen is visible at your end?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Okay.
Yes, sir. Sir.
Okay, please someone check whether the recording is on, yes or no. Just tell me.
Sir, it's already started.
Yes, sir.
Okay. Don't make it off. Huh? Don't make it off. Okay. Today I have taken one class without recording. So that's why. So let's start this class. So here in the last class, we have drawn those kind of waveform. Can you remember that kind of waveform?
Yes.
Now the thing is that from the knowledge of period, this is one period. Agree?
Yes, sir.
This is one period. So it is T, it is T, and again this is one period. It is T, it is T, it is T, and so on. In this case, this will be T. Yes or no? I am writing TA. Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
So in this case, this will be TA. A for flip-flop A. So TA, you assume, what is the value of T? Here, it is 2T. Okay? And?
Yes, sir.
And if equal to 1 by T, then F of A flip-flop equal to 1 by TA equal to 1 by T equal to F by 2. Okay, so we got,
sir,
it is a frequency division.
So actually, you are not told.
Ah, bolo.
Sir, it is a negative edge trigger clock, so shouldn't the T start from the negative edge?
No. Oh, whenever we are trying to define any period, there is no convention of starting and stopping. I can start my convention from this point and then I have to stop this point. Okay. What is the period? From the definition of period, I can start anywhere. For simplicity, yes. I have started from this edge. Okay. For simplicity. Okay. Now you observe. The frequency, it is the clock frequency. The clock frequency is suppose 100 hertz. Then FA will be 50 hertz. Agree? Then FA will be 50 hertz. Agree? So it is a frequency division. It is division by 2. Now you observe for period B. This will be one period, TB. Then again, this will be another period, TB. So in case of TB, I can find this region to this region. Okay, so 1, 2, 3, 4, 4T. So F of B equal to 1 by TB equal to 1 by 4T equal to F by 4. So FB frequency equal to F by 4. अगर 100 होता है तो 25 हर्ज
नहीं सर 25 हर्ज
सो इट इज अ डिवीजन बाय 4 सो सिमिलरली इट इज अ डिवीजन बाय 2 फॉर दिस इट इज अ डिवीजन बाय 4 फॉर दिस व्हाट विल बी डिवीजन बाय 8 एंड फॉर दिस इट विल बी डिवीजन बाय 16 ओके Are you getting my point?
Yes, sir.
So in this way, yes, we can reduce the frequency of the clock. Okay. So if we want to reduce the frequency, we can use this kind of solution. This solution was shown earlier in the last class. Okay. Let's proceed. Here, what kind of flip-flop has been used? SR or JK or D or T? What kind of flip-flop has been used? D. Okay. So it is a D flip-flop. Okay. Now, if we take the D flip-flop and the output is Q, this output is directly taken back and given the input of the last flip-flop. It is a 4-bit flip-flop because 4 flip-flops are there. Okay. 4-bit counter. So in this arrangement, if you take this kind of arrangement, output will be in this fashion or more precisely this fashion. Okay. So then this counter is called ring counter. Just you remember the diagram and you can easily draw. Okay. And I also told if I want to define the state diagram, then how to solve the problem? We solve the problem. Can you remember that solution? We have solved in T flip flop, then one assignment was given.
Yes,
and
sir.
You are asked to solve this one using T and D. Okay, so we can solve it.
Yes, sir.
Any student is facing any issue. Any student is facing any issue. Any student. For any student, please bolo. Okay, already you will get the less time. Because due to that means COVID pandemic, we will get less amount of class. So jaldi bolo kisi ka koi issue hai to. Nahi to aur bhi we will move forward, then you may face difficulty. Can you proceed, students? Can you proceed?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Now, in this case, instead of taking, you remember here we have given the feedback of Q. So here you have to give the feedback Q bar of the first flip flop. Okay, so in this fashion, it is called Johnson counter. It is called Johnson counter. The output sequence is shown over here. Okay, so whenever the feedback is taken from the Q bar, it is Johnson counter. When the feedback is taken from Q, it is a ring counter. Is it clear? So
yes,
I have block diagram. It is black box. So output is Q bar. So if this is taken, then it is ring counter. And if this is taken, then it is a Johnson counter. Just you remember. Okay. And then output, what will output? It will come. So you solve this one. Output will come definitely. Okay. That's it. Is it clear?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Now, how many states are there? How many states are there in this geometry? How many state? One state, two state, three state, four state. So it is a mod 4 counter. Is it clear?
Yes,
in this case,
Johnson and ring again.
Ring counter, you have to give
Johnson or ring counter.
वही मैं बोल रहा हूँ ना. सो रिंग काउंटर में यू हैव टू टेक द फीडबैक ऑफ क्यू. ओके. एंड जॉनसन काउंटर में यू हैव टू टेक द फीडबैक ऑफ क्यू बार. दैट्स द डिफरेंस, नथिंग एल्स. ओके. ऑल काउंटर आर सिंक्रोनस. यू चेक क्लॉक आर सिंक्रोनस. ऑल क्लॉक आर सिंक्रोनस. ओके. सो नाउ इन जॉनसन काउंटर इन दिस फिगर, वन स्टेट, टू स्टेट, three state, that is the fourth state, that is the fifth state, that is the sixth. How many states are there? Six states are there. So it is a mod 6 counter. Okay. Mod 6 counter means how number of states it can count. So that's why it is a mod 6 counter. Here it can count maximum 4 state. That's why it is a mod 4 counter. Is it clear?
Sir.
Is it clear? Yes.
Sir, it is clear. Sir, is it compulsory that ring counter will be mod 4 counter only? Or
no. I told about the mod counter related to ring counter. I told how many states are there. Now just count the number of state. Okay, don't bother about what is ring counter, what is Johnson counter. Okay, suppose in any state problem, let's talk about one diagram. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. How many states are there? Bolo.
10 states,
sir.
All are wrong. No one is following class properly. Because it is not a state, because I didn't give arrow.
Direction.
I have to give arrow.
It's not a sequence.
Suppose I'm giving sequence. Now I'm giving sequence. Arbitrarily, I'm giving sequence. So the sequence is 1, 2, 1, 2, then 10, then 8, then 3, 9, 4, 6, 5, 7, then again 1. Okay. Now count the number of states. First state, second state, third state, fourth state, fifth state, sixth, seventh, eighth, ninth, ten. Total 10 number of states are there. So it is a mod 10 counter. Okay. Is it clear?
Yes, sir.
Okay, so don't be confused with Johnson counter or ring counter. Just for any counter, count the number of state. That is your mod number. Okay, so let's proceed. We have already learned this thing. Okay, but still, if we write this thing, 0, 0, 0, 0, 1, 1, 0, 1, 1. 0, 0, 0, 1, 1, 0, 1, 1. It is not any sequence. It is just some bits are written arbitrarily. So it is not a counter. But whenever I am giving the arrow sign, now it becomes a counter because we know its sequence after which it will come. Now it is a downward counting, na? From 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, 0, then again.
Yes, sir.
So downward. So it is a down counter. D-O-U-N-T-E-R. Down counter. Is it clear?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Very good. Now suppose. Suppose I'm giving in this way. I have just reversed the arrow. Then it is in increasing order. So then it will be up counter. Then how to design the flip-flop or circuit? We have already learned this. Okay. So don't put in. So the thing is that in this way, we can easily define the up counter and down counter. So that's the end. That's the end of the basic electronics. That means digital circuit. Let's try to start our new topic. Okay. We cannot waste our time. Huh? Otherwise, I could have given the holiday today. Let's try to start our class. Okay, let's try to start. Tum log ka class kab hoga? When will be your last class? As per our notification, first semester kab khatam hoga?
Sir, February 28.
Oh, that means within February we have to solve all prop syllabus. Okay, let's try to solve. Now let's try to diode. Okay, suppose I'm drawing one simple geometry. What is the notation of this kind of gate?
Not.
It is a not gate.
Sir.
It is not gate. But here, if I use this kind of notation, then it becomes a diode.
Diode.
Then it becomes a diode. Now the thing is that this port.
Sir.
Suppose it is A, huh?
Sir, in this semester our syllabus will say reduce.
I do not know. Whatever we will teach, that will be your syllabus. Dekho, don't bother about syllabus. If the syllabus is reduced, suppose instead of 5 chapters, we learn 3 chapters. After 2 years, nobody will ask bother you, that means nobody will bother about that means corona. They will ask, oh, you didn't learn those three, four, and fifth chapters. Oh, you do not know anything. Are you getting my point? So it is better to, syllabus will be reduced, obviously, but still try to learn as many as possible. Whatever we can cover, we will try to learn. Huh? So that's why. So let's try to proceed. So it is A, it is B. So current will flow from this point to this point. Okay? So that's why this node is called anode. And this node is called cathode. Okay. Now, the thing is that I told the current will flow in this direction always. So if I add one battery, this battery is AC or DC? Kaunsa hoga? AC or DC? Kaunsa hai? Bolo.
DC.
Plus minus. So as the current will flow in this direction, so I have to connect this positive terminal with the anode. So current will flow in this direction.
Forward bias.
Forward bias. But in this case, we should draw at least one resistor. At least one resistor, okay, to control the amount of current flow. Otherwise, what will happen? Due to the excessive voltage, the current will generate in excessive amount. Okay, so what will happen if a certain limit is attained? The diode may damage. Okay, to limit the current, we normally add one resistor. R variable resistor, and by adjusting by increasing its value or by reducing its value, we normally try to obtain a suitable range of current. So that the diode cannot damage and it can work properly. Is it clear?
Yes, sir. Yeah.
Okay. Now, yes. Suppose this terminal A and B. So it is, and the voltage VA greater than VB, and the diode is connected in this way. Then current will flow in this way. Okay. So
in short,
we will assume the voltage difference between AB is nearly equal to zero for short circuit case, because current is flowing, no voltage drop. It is a one kind of approximation. Actual voltage drop is, suppose here it is 6-3 volt, then here it will be at least 5 volt. At least 0.6 or 0.7 volt should be higher. But in normal, most of the problem, we try to avoid those kind of voltage difference. So we normally assume if it is connected with forward bias conditions, then we normally consider it is a short circuit. So let's try to draw one circuit. This is my one port. This is one resistor. This one, and this is the ground. Here I have given 10 volt. Here it is 1 kilo ohm. Okay. Now it is my A terminal and it is my B terminal. Agree? As per the convention?
Yes, sir.
Now yes. You observe VAB, we as per our notations, forward bias condition, VAB we will assume 0 volt. Agree?
Yes, sir.
So the amount of current, suppose can be calculated in this way, 10 minus VAB divided by R is nothing but 10 minus 0, R is nothing but 1 kilo ohm. So it is 10 milliampere. Is it clear?
Yes, sir.
So in this way, we can solve simple problem. Let's change this orientation. Let's change the orientation of the diode. Same problem. I have changed the orientation. So now it is my A and it will be my B. Okay. Now it is plus 10 volt. Now VB under greater than in VA. So there will be no current flow. Agree?
Yes, sir.
Because there is a barrier, we will learn in details later. Okay, later we will learn. Okay, so there is a huge barrier, so there will be no current flow. So in this region, suppose the current I will be simple zero. So here VB will be nothing but total voltage minus voltage drop across this resistor, that is 1K. Huh? So as the current is zero, so 10 volt minus R into I, this R into I is the voltage drop across this resistor. Okay, so 10 volt minus R value into current is zero, because there will no current flow, na? There will be no current flow because VB greater than VA.
Yes, sir.
So VB. So VB will be 10 volt. Okay, so VB will be 10 volt. So now you observe, in this case, we will get zero voltage. If we change the orientation, here we are getting 10 voltage. So that's the beauty of using diode. Okay.
Forward and reverse bias.
Yes. This condition is called forward. This condition is called forward biased. And this condition is called reverse bias. Is it clear?
Yes, sir.
Is there any doubt for any student? तुम लोग पढ़े हो क्या 10+2 में पढ़े हो डायोड?
यस सर,
थोड़ा सर।
कोई बात नहीं, हाँ ठीक है, हम लोग भी थोड़ा ही पढ़ेंगे, डोंट बिकॉज इट इज बेसिक इलेक्ट्रॉनिक्स क्लास. नाउ वी लर्न डीसी. Now, what will happen if we give AC source? Okay, so assume, now I am assuming the current is flowing in this direction. So current will flow, but zero volt, short circuit. So it is my A, it is my B. In this case, if I attach the diode in this way, no current. Okay. Open circuit, OC. You have to remember these two notation, open circuit. Okay. So now let's try to define what will happen if we give the AC source. So let's define one AC signal. This is my AC. Then I am giving one resistance, limiting resistance to control the amount of current. Suppose this is my diode. Then I am placing one resistance. And I'm connecting this one, and I am evaluating, or I am observing the voltage VR, and load. This is my output voltage, yes, load. So V naught, if we make it load, so it can be considered as a VL, L for load, output for O, V naught, and if the resistance is R, so VR, any notation you can use it. Okay, now the AC signal is this one. Okay, suppose for simplicity we are assuming it is 10 volt and it is minus 10 volt and the wave is propagating. Okay, let's try to define what will happen.
Half wave rectifier.
I do not know what is rectifier. Let's investigate and define whether it is a rectifier or something else. Okay. This is my input VN. The input. So suppose this is my signal.
Sir, change the color of pen.
Yes. Sure. Suppose my input signal is this one. And I am showing two cycle, not circle. Okay. And what is the amplitude? Suppose it is 10 volt. And in the bottom one, it is also minus 10 volt. Okay. Please pardon me because I am using freehand drawing using electronically. in the electronic media. So that's why it is a little bit difficult. If I use the that means blackboard, then there will be no issue. So just you assume this one. Now, in this case, what is the voltage? Suppose, what is the voltage in this point? Assume, in this point, what is the voltage? Suppose 2 voltage. In this point, suppose 6 voltage. In this point, suppose 10 voltage. Okay. Now, whatever the region, doesn't matter. In this cycle, the voltage is always greater than 0. Agree? In this region, the voltage is always greater than 0. Agree?
Yes, sir.
So the thing is that as in the first half cycle in this, so it is greater than 0. So it is higher potential and it is, and this node, this point lower means here. So it is lower potential. So there will be current flow. Agree? The amount may change. Yes, doesn't matter. But yes, at sir. Least there will be yes, current sir. Flow. Because this A node, now it is higher position, higher potential, and B as lower potential. So whatever the voltage I will get similar kind of output over here. So that's why in the output, that means V naught, I will get similar kind of voltage up to this one. The amplitude may change, but nature will be same. Okay. Is it clear?
Yes, sir.
Okay, now.
Hello, sir.
Yes, bolo.
So the graph, the area where V is greater than 0 is the potential difference between A and B.
Yes, potential difference between A and B. So here we are assuming in this region, you take any one point. Okay, in this curve, from this point graph to this line, you take any one point, its amplitude will be always greater than 0. As it is greater than 0, so whenever I am giving this signal, suppose it is Vp sine of omega t. So this amplitude is nothing but Vp. Okay. So then what will happen in the first cycle, in the first half cycle, so its amplitude is always greater than 0. So as it is greater than 0, so there will be higher potential. Okay. And there will be lower potential. So now the forward bias condition is set up as per our normal assumption, because the potential difference between that should be 0 volt, short circuit, SC condition. Okay. So in this case, there will be current flow. So in this way, I will get this kind of output. So this will be my Vp approximately. Is it clear right now? Is it clear?
Sir, I am asking the area. Yeah, you said it. What does it signify?
No, don't bother about area. We are not talking about the area over here. I am talking about in this region, if you take any one point. Okay, so on the curve. So that's why. So if you take this point, what is the amplitude? It can have certain amplitude. Suppose it is 2 volt. What is the amplitude over here? Suppose 6 volt. So whenever it is 6 volt, so here it will be 6 volt and B here will be 0 volt. So that's why A will be always at higher potential with respect to B potential. Okay, B point. So that's why there will be a forward bias condition. So that's why there will be current flow, and current will pass through in this way. Is it clear?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So now the first half cycle is over. It is described over here. Now let's define the negative half cycle.
For next half, it will be reverse bias.
Let's check kya hota hai, mujhe pata nahi. एक बार पोज देंगे तो सो देयर विल बी ह्यूज इशू. सो लेट्स ड्रॉ द सेम सर्किट. ओके, नाउ इन दी नाउ दिस नेगेटिव हाफ साइकिल इज गिविंग. सो एज वी आर गिविंग नेगेटिव हाफ साइकिल, देयर विल बी माइनस 2 वोल्ट, there will be minus 6 volt, then minus 10 volt, and so on. So as we are giving, so there will be negative voltage and there will be some 0 volt. So it is a reverse bias condition. It is reverse bias condition. So in this case, there will be no current. So in this case, there will be no current, and this circuit will see one open circuit. This circuit will see one open circuit like this. So there will be no current flow. Okay, so total voltage will appear over here. That means there will be no current flow. So total voltage will appear in this point. Now we are trying to find the voltage over here. So current I, so as it is open circuit, I will be zero. So as I will be zero, so in this voltage, the voltage drop V naught will be R into I. So that means 0 volt. So in this region, I will get totally no voltage in the output. Is it clear?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So now, again, the first half cycle has been encountered. So this working principle of this region and this region will be similar. Similar working principle.
Yes, sir.
So again, I will get one half cycle. Now this region and this region, similar working principle. So I will not get any output, sir, over here. So and we will proceed in this way. Okay. So that is the beauty. What will happen if we feed one AC or if we connect one AC source with a diode with some resistance, and if we are taking the output across any load, then this kind of wave can come. Okay. So in this case, we found only one wave is coming at the output. So that's why it is called half wave rectifier. Okay. Only one half. Because we have two half, again another half, so total of only one half is coming at the output port. That means V naught. That's why it is called half wave rectifier. We will learn also details in later how to make it half wave, full wave, lots of circuits. Okay, but as we learn, what will happen if we give a AC source? That's why it is coming. That's why I have told. Okay. Is it clear?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Now let's. क्या हो गया? I think slide खत्म हो गया. Oh. तो न्यू स्लाइड रिकॉर्डिंग हो रहा है. हाँ, आउट ऑफ 158 स्टूडेंट ओनली 141. ओके, बाकी स्टूडेंट कहाँ पे है भाई? कैसे पास करेगा सब लोग? ओके, नाउ let's proceed next topic. Now if I apply the same thing but in reverse bias, but in opposite direction.
Sir, in the half wave rectifier, time period and frequency remains constant.
So we will discuss later. Now here we are giving just only introduction. ओके, अभी वो सब डिस्कस मत करो. हाँ, क्योंकि वो टाइम ले चाहिए सब बोलने के लिए बहुत कुछ.
ओके सर.
सो इफ आई चेंज द ओरिएंटेशन ऑफ डायोड, व्हाट विल हैपन? फर्स्ट पॉजिटिव हाफ साइकिल इट इज ओपन. ओके, सो व्हाट विल हैपन? सो आई विल गेट ओनली अ कॉन्स्टेंट लाइन इन द आउटपुट. I will get a constant line in the output. But when we are giving the negative half cycle, that means this cycle, so then what will happen? So this will be short circuit. This will be treated as short circuit. Okay, because now it is in opposite directions. So here it is higher potential, here it is lower potential, so current will flow. Okay, short circuit, so there will current flow, one current will flow throughout this region, so I will get one current. So negative half cycle, I will come in this way. So again short circuit, then again this way. In this way, we will get the result. It is also half wave rectifier.
Sir.
Okay.
Sir, I didn't get it.
Did you get this portion? Did you get this portion? Hello.
Hello, sir.
Did you get this one? How sir, it is coming in?
Sir, I was facing some network issues.
Oh,
that's why.
So I have discussed those
on
things.
On the ninth slide, actually.
Ninth slide. It is on. No, no. That's why I'm asking. Did you get slide number eight correctly, properly? Did you get this slide properly? Okay.
Yes,
now
sir,
here, what we got, give? We have just interchanged the orientation of diode. If I interchange the orientation of diode, so whenever I will give positive input, so it will be open circuit. Positive input, open circuit, na? Because here it is positive, here it is negative voltage potential. That's why, or we can say in terms of zero, we can say it is positive value, it is zero value. So open circuit. Okay. Now in this case, but in the reverse cycle here, it will be short circuited. Okay, so that's why there will be current flow. Obviously, current will flow in this direction because it's negative. So it will pass the negative pulse. So that's why we will get one kind of negative pulse. So that it is also half wave rectifier. Okay.
So the direction will be opposite to the before slide you have shown.
We didn't calculate. Just we have shown one kind of current will flow. That's why. If I give the current, so current will flow in this orientation always. Okay. Because the orientation of diode is in this direction. Na? So here, orientation of diode in this way. So current will flow in this way. As the voltage is negative, that's why it will come in negative direction. We will solve one or two problems how to compute this voltage. Don't worry. It is just one example. So what will happen if we give AC source? Okay, so just we are in the starting phase, that's why. Now, okay. Suppose I have VA. Undo hota hai, control Z se? Nahi hota hai. Now, suppose I have voltage VA and I have VB. Then I have connected those two part. Okay, then I'm taking the output and I'm taking this one in this way output. It is my ground. It is my V naught. Let's assume what will happen. VA equal to zero. VB equal to zero. Will there be any current flow? Will there be any current flow? Yes or no?
No, sir.
V naught will be zero. Agree? V naught will be zero. Agree?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Now assume VA equal to 0 volt, VB equal to 5 volt. So if it is 5 volt across this diode, 5 volt. So current will flow in this direction, na? In this direction current will flow. Agree?
Yes, sir.
As per our simple assumption, it will be short circuited, so voltage drop will be across the diode will be 0 volt. So total 5 volt will appear over here. So what will be the voltage at V naught? What will be the voltage V naught? 5 volt. Agree?
Yes, sir.
Agree? Yes, sir.
Is there any doubt? Is there any doubt for any student?
No, sir.
Okay. Let's use different color. 3. Suppose VA equal to 5 volt and VB equal to 0 volt. So now here we have 0 volt. Here we have 5 volt. So now here there will be current flow. Agree?
Yes, sir.
So it will be acts as a short circuit. This diode, as it will act as a short circuit, so voltage drop across the diode will be 0 volt as per our simple assumption. So total 5 volt. So total 5 volt will appear in this junction. Agree? So V naught will be 5 volt. V naught will be 5 volt. Is it clear? Is it clear? Is it clear? Any doubt? Any doubt?
No, sir.
Okay, now let's fourth one. Suppose VA equal to 5 volt, VB equal to 5 volt. Then both circuit will act. Both circuit will act. Okay, and both diode will act as a short circuit. And what will happen? Zero voltage will appear. So current will flow in this direction and current will flow in this direction. But here we have adjusted one resistance. Okay. So what will happen? See, total voltage will be over here. So V naught will be 5 volt. Okay.
So V naught should be 10 volt.
It is more than 5 volt, but we are talking about approximately. Okay. Because we want to find this connection with some kind of logic gate, okay? Now, you assume 0 plus 0 equal to 0, we first get, we obtain 0 plus 0 equal to 0. Then 0 plus 1, we obtain 1. Then 1 plus 0, we obtain 1. And here we obtain 1 plus 1 equal to 1. Okay, what kind of gate? What kind of gate?
OR gate.
It is an OR gate. So V equal to A plus B. Okay, so we can easily implement this thing using OR gate, using diode. It is a simple circuit. The actual voltage will not be 5 volt, but here we are giving approximate analysis, not exact analysis, so that we can use the diode to design, to implement one kind of gate. Is it clear? Is it clear?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So one assignment will be there. Bolo.
Sir. Sir, if VA is 6 volt and VBB 5 volts, and what should we take is V naught?
V naught?
Sir, VA should be 10 volt and VB should be 5 volt. Then what should be the value of V naught? We should take 5 volt or 10 volt?
You can take 10 volt. No, don't bother about voltage. You focus, we learn na, logic 1 and logic 0. Logic 0 normally called as 0 volt, logic 1 5 volt or 10 volt. So we are trying to implement one digital gate. Okay, so don't bother about 10 volt. So if you are using one 10 voltage, so other voltage has to be taken 10 voltage. Na. We cannot have intermediate data, either 0 logic, either 1 logic. Is it clear?
Yes, sir.
The thing is that here the total actual exact voltage will not be 5 voltage, but we have to compute it. But we can easily compute using simple circuit analysis, but we will learn later whenever we will try to solve some numerical problem. Here we are trying to solve the problem qualitatively, okay, not quantitatively. So that's why we have written 5 volt. Okay, so here if the circuit is found, it is a OR gate. So there will be one assignment, implement spelling is wrong. Implement AND gate, 3 input AND gate using diode. Okay, same thing. If you know the 2 input AND gate or 3 input, easily ho jayega, koi issue nahi hoga, sirf ek add karna padega. So this will be our what number of assignment? Let me check. This will be our 6. Yes, very good.
Segment 6, sir.
Yes, 6. This will be our assignment 6. Okay.
सर सबमिशन डेट फरवरी 7
2022 2022 2022 2022 2022 2022 2022 2022 2022 2022 2022 2022 2022 2022 2022 2022 2022 2022 2022 2022 2022 2022 2022 2022 2022 2022 2022 2022 2022 2022 2022 2022 2022 2022 2022 2022 2022 2022 2022 2022 2022 2022 2022 2022 2022 2022 2022 2022 2022 2022 2022 2022 2022 2022 2022 2022 2022 2022 2022 2022 2022 2022 2022 2022 2022 2022 2022 2022 2022 2022 2022 2022 2022 2022 2022 2022 2022 2022 2022 2022 2022 2022 2022 2022 2022 2022 2022 2022 2022 2022 2022 2022 2022 2022 2022 2022 2022 2022 2022 2022 2022 2022 2022 2022 2022 2022 2022 2022 2022 2022 2022 2022 2022 2022 2022 2022 2022 2022 2022 2022 2022 2022 2022 2022 2022 2022 2 in the campus and if you are giving क्या बोलते हैं एंड सेमिस्टर देयर विल बी नो इशू वी कैन इजीली एडजस्ट बट एटलीस्ट टीए मार्क्स में मार्क्स होना चाहिए ना सो दैट्स व्हाई सो दैट्स
व्हाई वी आर ऑलरेडी सो वी हैव फाइव असाइनमेंट्स इफ यू गिव अस लाइक हां
सभी लोग देंगे सभी लोग देंगे
या सो लाइक इफ यू गिव अस 4 मार्क्स फॉर ईच असाइनमेंट देन वी ऑलरेडी हैव आवर 20 मार्क्स
we are not giving who told I am giving 4 marks I am giving 0.5 marks then
if we get some more time for this assignment then that would be like good
I will
for
give
us,
definitely
sir.
1 week don't worry but not more than 1 week
yes okay? sir so we need because, so like a rest period of 1 week and after that 1 week for the assignment sir like every week we are going to submit one assignment so that is being a bit hectic for us sir
not hectic you have only 5-6 chapter subject na so you have to do agar tum log yahan pe bhi hoga tab bhi assignment dena padta main to har class mein deta hu 10 bara assignment yahan pe bhi dunga ha basic electronics mein 10 bara assignment nahi dunga to kab dunga at least if you are practicing then you can learn theek hai so isliye डोंट वरी अगर थोड़ा करो देन यू विल लर्न हेक्टिक डोंट यूज दोज वर्ड्स ठीक है लेट्स स्टार्ट अभी तो सिर्फ शुरू है अभी तो असाइनमेंट आया ही नहीं अभी तो ट्रांजिस्टर पढ़ना बाकी है ऑप एम्प बाकी है बहुत कुछ बाकी है डोंट वरी वी विल कम
सो लेट्स सर शुरुआत से ही ऐसे हो जा रहे सर उसमें और क्या ही होगा सर तो स्टार्टिंग में थोड़ा कम दे दीजिए
इसीलिए बोल रहा हूँ व्हेनेवर वी आर गिविंग वन असाइनमेंट सो यू सॉल्व इट इमीडिएटली ना बिकॉज यू आर लर्निंग दिस टॉपिक सेम टाइम सपोज द डेडलाइन इज 26 जनवरी एंड यू हैव स्टार्टेड टू सॉल्व द प्रॉब्लम ऑन 25 जनवरी देन इट बिकम्स हेक्टिक ओके सो आई डू ऑलवेज सॉल्व द प्रॉब्लम अर्लियर ओके जब बीटेक में था बहुत लेट करता था उसके बाद लेट नहीं किया जब भी असाइनमेंट होता पहले कर लेते थे क्योंकि टाइम नहीं मिलता है ना इसलिए दैट्स व्हाई ओके लेट्स ट्राई टू लेट्स हाँ अभी तो टाइम नहीं है अभी 5 मिनट बाकी है जस्ट वेट 1 मिनट एक चीज पढ़ा देता हूँ सपोज ओके बिफोर स्टार्टिंग दिस थिंग वी शुड लर्न समथिंग नाउ हाउ टू मेक वन डायोड सपोज वी हैव पी टाइप सेमीकंडक्टर एंड वी हैव एन टाइप सेमीकंडक्टर ओके नाउ व्हाट विल हैपन इफ आई कनेक्ट दिस टू then I should get this kind of PN junction yes or no
yes sir
yes or no
yes
so how to connect should I use blue Fevikwik Fevicol
no sir
okay so we cannot connect this thing so it is not possible blue cannot be possible so we have to use one kind of that means the okay. length of this one is semiconductor okay so we have to take this semiconductor then up to this one we have to dope with p type material and here we have to dope with n type material in this way we will get a continuous transition between a p material and a n material we do not have to connect separately a p material and n material to make one diode is it clear
Yes, sir.
So now the current flow through a diode can be explained in this simple equation e to the power of Vd divided by eta Vt minus 1. Here I naught is reverse saturation current. Okay, if the problem comes, it will be given. Vd is the potential difference. Vd is the potential difference between two terminal A and B. okay, between the diode. Vt, okay, Vt, it has the specific value Kt by Q, and in simple way you can compute T by 11600, okay, volt. T is in Kelvin temperature, okay. K is Boltzmann constant, Q is the charge of electron. So it is after computing all those things, you will get this thing. So when a particular temperature will be given, you use this equation, you will get the result. Now here, eta, it is one for germanium. Okay, for germanium kind of diode, and if the diode is made using silicon, eta will be 2. Okay, so it will be given. Whenever one problem will be given, then those values will be given, so you don't have to be worried. Okay, is it clear?
Sir, yes, sir. Where this formula came?
How to obtain that formula?
Yes, sir.
The thing is that the derivations of this formula in the that means normally I do derive in the basic electronics class. At least we tell something how to derive all those things. But as we have less class, I cannot derive. One lecture is required how to obtain the potential difference. तो टाइम नहीं है अगर एक्स्ट्रा अगर 28 फरवरी के बाद तुम लोग बोलोगे एक्स्ट्रा क्लास करने आओगे देन आई विल डिराइव देयर विल बी नो इशू हां बट एटलीस्ट यू कैन फॉर द टाइम बीइंग यू कैन बट द थिंग इज दैट इट इज आल्सो बियॉन्ड योर सिलेबस इन फर्स्ट ईयर वी डू नॉट टीच बट स्टिल आई डू टीच इन माय सेक्शन सो इफ यू गेट टाइम आफ्टर द 28 फरवरी देन आई विल डेफिनेटली टीच अदरवाइज आई विल नॉट डिराइव क्योंकि बाकी सिलेबस खत्म नहीं होगा तो फिर थोड़ा बहुत ठीक है सो डोंट बदर अबाउट द डेरिवेशन So if you plot this graph in the positive case only, suppose here we are giving, so I will get this kind of curve. So here we are giving the current ID and here we are giving the potential VD. Okay, because the expression is nothing but ID is nothing but IS e to the power of Vd divided by eta Vt minus 1. Okay, it is a standard. Okay, the position where it starts. Okay, so the position where it starts, it's called the cut-in voltage. Okay, it's normally it has specific value. It is normally becomes 0.3 voltage for germanium. It's the value, if the value is coming to 0.6 to 0.7 voltage, then it is silicon. Okay, then it is silicon. Okay, so most of the time we use silicon. So because that's why we use most of the time 0.7 voltage. So if I have one voltage and I am giving a diode here and here zero voltage, so it will be on because 1 voltage minus 0 voltage, that is 1 voltage, which is greater than 0.7 voltage. Okay, but if I am giving here 1.5 voltage and here 1 voltage, so 1.5 minus 1, that means 0.5 voltage, which is less than 0.7 voltage, so it will be off. Okay, so in this way we normally compute whether a diode will be on or off. Okay, is it clear?
Yes, sir.
Okay, so I think the time is over, na? So I think it is 4:10.
Yes, sir.
Okay, so let's stop today.
Yes, sir.
Let's stop today. In the next class, we will try to do some mathematics or some problem along with some physical understanding. Okay. So let's stop today. So let me take the attendance. Wait, just 1 minute. Yes, now I have taken the attendance. Now you can leave for other class. Okay.